Welcome back to The Breakfast on PLOS TV Africa. Nigeria has been ranked 161 out of 181 countries on the Global Youth Index. The index, of course, measures youth around the world and the level of growth and development that youth in each country basically get to experience. It of course puts education, employment, health, and some other details into perspective. We're speaking this morning with a policy strategist, Dayo Israel. Good morning, and thanks for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for having me. Good morning.
Thanks for being with us. I'm going to start with asking, if this, came as a surprise or in any way a shock to you. It's international, it's Youth Day, but, would you read a story like this and say, oh, that's shocking. Nigerian youth seem to be doing a lot better than 161st position.
So first, I wanted to say happy International Youth Day to young people all over the world, particularly in Africa and young men, who are trying every day to make the best out of themselves and their environment and their career, and despite the challenges that come with living on this continent of Africa. Because for many years, living on the continent of Africa has been very challenging for young Africans. There have been rising issues of unemployment, there have been issues of lack of access to proper healthcare, lack of access to basic education, lack of access to, a lot of ravaging conflicts across Africa, from Rwanda to Congo, Brazzaville, to DRC, and to many other parts of the continent. Even the young people in Nigeria, for example, for many years in the military role, face some more challenges. But with the return of democracy to our country and also the widespread of the democracy on the continent, we have begun to see gains in youth development across the continent. And so a day like this is to celebrate 75% of the population of this continent. Who holds the future? Who are going to be the ones to sustain the development and the change that the leaders of today are making? And that is why on this youth day, we're calling for stronger engagement of young people and participation of young people in policy making and issues that concern us. Because if we are building a future for us, without us, then you're not really giving a future for us. But who's going to sustain that change that you're trying to make? And that's why I'm happy and what I see in some parts of Africa. For example, in Lagos, where you have a lot of young people represented in policy issues in the cabinet. For example, in Lagos, our commissioner for finance is a 60-year-old young man. Our commissioner for agri is also at the age range. And also the commissioner for innovation and creativity. Is our special advisor in innovation and security. And we see that in different agencies of government across Nigeria. That is one index that we can measure, for example, that we're making progress in development. So, of course, we also have a lot of special assistance of governors and senior assistants of governors. But the reality of that is, in many other states, we will see many of that for youth development alone. But actually, when I see states like also Lagos and Nasarawa, the Commissioner for Finance in Nasarawa, economic planning as well, and I think so in Cote d'Ivoire and a few other Southwest states, and of course Lagos, are people who are of our generation, the younger generation, and who are getting a chance to be able to prove themselves, to be able to make a difference, to be able to blaze the trail, to be able to show capacity, and also to be able to effect change in issues that concern us. So that metric is just on youth participation. If we now look at youth employment, what we've seen on the continent of Africa is that over the years, there have been challenges about employment. Our population is blowing up every day. Now you realize that we can't, or the society does not have enough jobs to engage the energy of our generation. And what young people are excited about is that the young people are not waiting for government to give us a job. We're creating the job in ways that they don't even understand. And so, you see a lot of young people, yes, it doesn't mean that they're not too bad ends who are doing the wrong thing to make money. But the reality is that there are plenty good ends who are doing the legit thing to raise money, and they are raising unimaginable kind of funding from private equity, from, venture capitalists. I'm talking, for example, this company, Panda, for example. You have all these tech companies, IT companies, CEE, Inyolu Aboyeji, and Dela, You know, companies like that who are raising $500 million, who are raising $100,000, who are raising $100 million, who are raising $10 million, $20 million to drive growth, to create jobs, to revive the economy. And you know, before it used to be about working in our companies. Now some of these young people are making money that even five companies today cannot earn because of their creativity, the tech abilities that they have, the building have. So in terms of the economy, it's not fully spread yet, but we're also making little progress at the size of the hand of a man. But that's showing that young people are also driving and not waiting for government to build economic stability for us. We are coming out to make a difference. So in terms of youth participation, we're seeing growth. In terms of employment, we're seeing growth. In terms of education, we have more young people who are also...
Mr. Israel, can you hold on? I want us to take these indices one step at a time, right? You've talked about politics, and you've also talked about the economy regarding employment. Let's talk. Go back to the issue of politics, because the indices they use, politics, economic, they used employment, they use health, inequality, and all of that. So going back to politics, I know you mentioned a few people, especially in Lagos, that seem to be doing well. They are young people, and they're representing Nigerians in their different constituencies. But generally, you find that in Nigeria, the political voice we hear almost seems to be limited to the social media space. It seems Nigerians are fired up for advocacy. But really, when it comes to now putting their money where their mouth is, regarding, you know, vying for these political offices and as well as even coming out to vote, there seems to be something missing. You know, voter apathy in the last local government elections we've seen. And you also consider things like, you know, high cost of nomination fees, you know, to buy nomination forms and things like that, that seem to limit us. But how do you think we can get past these limitations to make sure that more youth get a seat at the table?
So the reality is that the challenges exist and prevail. And I'm going to be honest with you. The challenges are so systemic that you need a long-term approach to solve them. They've been built by people who have been in the system for many years, 20, 30 years of systemic creation that, you know, we can't literally finish in a year because of a lot of the apathy that our people have. But in the midst of that systemic challenge that we see across the country, we're also seeing some progress. So, for example, in the Lagos State local government election I just conducted, we have a fantastic young barrister who is the chairman of Koshofe local government, a young man, under 40. You know, we as well have faced challenges before. He had run for House of Assembly, he didn't get, you know, as a candidate, he didn't win the election. He ran for chairman, he didn't win the election. But this time around, he's able to get his aspiration and able to become the chairman of Koshofe local government. We have many other young people, the vice chairman of which will be for a local government. We have the chairman of the Korea Valley Day local government. Of course, like I said, this is still a little proportion, but we're seeing the signs of progress. What we have to do is, you know, as far as we are mentioning, what we say, power is not served a la carte. We're not going to get this, it's not a marathon, it's not a sprint, it's not a short race. We've got to push in our effort and our best into it, and know that this is a long-term journey. It's not going to be a victory in one day. I'm being through this myself. I contested for House of Assembly, I contested for local government challenges, and I didn't get the ticket for both elections. But I didn't give up. I kept on pushing and pushing. Today I sit on the board of the Labour State Universal Education Board, helping to support quality assurance and a lot of other activities led by the chairman of Tibet. I'm providing it to. I'm the youngest person on the board. And for all my colleagues on the board and for executive chairman, I provide a fresh perspective of young people. So I may not have been elected, but I'm standing on that board, supporting them with our fresh ideas, supporting them with my youthful energy, and that's another channel to leadership. So we might not get into the elective offices because we don't have, and see, it's not going to finish in a day. The system is woven to push and to resist the emerging generation. But thank God that in places like Lagos and Ogun State and other parts of Nigeria, like I said, in the South South, you're beginning to see an opening where we're beginning to get a seat at the table. And I said to young people, if they don't give you a seat at the table, go and make your own chair and bring it to the table.
Fantastic
and that's what
way
we're
to
doing
wrap
now.
It up, Mr. Israel. Fantastic way to wrap it up. If they don't give you a seat at the table, build yours. Thank you very much, policy strategist Mr. Tayo Israel, and happy International Youth Day.
Thank you.
Okay, so we'll continue the conversation we began yesterday, actually all week long, regarding the All Progressives Congress and the legitimacy of the chairmanship of May Malabuni, governor of Yobe State, regarding that caretaker committee. This was debated in court. The Supreme Court gave its judgment and lots of controversies there over if Buni should resign or not. Let's talk about that after the break.